In one of our other videos, we talked about string digital-to-analogue converters. This architecture is simple in structure, but at higher resolutions, it quickly leads to large circuits with many resistors. In this video, we will introduce an R2R DAC. Compared to the string DAC, the number of resistors needed is much smaller. For each bit of resolution, only one resistor with a value of R ohm and one resistor with a value of 2 times R ohm are needed. R can be any resistance value. An R2R DAC is based on the principle of a binary weighted voltage section. Therefore, only one switch is needed for each bit of resolution. The 2R branch in parallel with each 1R resistor in series creates this binary weighting. The switches are connected either to ground or to the reference voltage. Let's now familiarize ourselves with how an R2R ladder DAC and binary weighting works. For this, we will use the concept of equivalent circuits and superposition. Applying the reference voltage to a branch results in a voltage at the DAC output. Let's take the example of the 3-bit R2R ladder and apply the corresponding equivalent circuit to determine the voltage contribution of each part. When a bit of code is set to 1 in an R2R ladder network, the corresponding switch in the ladder provides the reference voltage on that branch. Conversely, when a bit is set to 0, the branch is connected to ground. First, let's start with the contribution of the first voltage source V1. All other voltage sources, except V1, are according to the equivalent circuit shorted to ground. For now, we will use this assumption to calculate the voltage contribution at the output, as V1/2 is given by the simple resistor divider created by the equivalent resistance when looking back into the ladder branches. Next, we consider the voltage source V2. Again, we know that looking back into the ladder indicates a resistance of 2R, so we can immediately redraw the circuit to take this into account. Now we create a cut line into which we insert the equivalent circuit, that means a voltage source of V2/2 and a resistor of R. This R is combined with the R now in series in the ladder and leads to this new circuit. We now see that the contribution of the second branch to the output voltage is V2/4. Finally, we look at the contribution of the last input voltage. We see that the equivalent voltage is V3/4. This results in a contribution of V3/8 to Vout through the voltage divider. We can see how the pattern would continue at the higher resolution. By superposition, the branch at the most significant bit contributes a voltage of V1/2, the next branch contributes V2/4, and the last branch contributes V3/8. Based on the reference voltage and the individual bits in the DAC code, we can then develop an equation for the ladder. Extending this to the number of m branches in the resistive ladder gives this equation. In the example shown here with a 3-bit DAC, which is set to code 110, we can apply the equation we just developed. Note the position of the switches, where the blue switch is connected to ground and the red switches are connected to VREF. Putting this into the equation, the DAC output is 6/8 of the reference voltage. This is exactly what we would expect for the output voltage for the binary code 110 in a 3-bit DAC. A big advantage of the R2R ladder architecture is that more complex trimming techniques can be used, because there are fewer resistors in the design. This leads to better linearity overall. Looking at the R2R topology, it is noticeable that the reference node of an R2R DAC has a dynamic input impedance. In general, it is not desirable for a reference source to undergo a dynamic impedance change, as the reference voltage needs time to adjust to the new impedance. If the application requires rapid cycling of codes, there may not be time to wait while the reference settles with each transition. For this reason, it is highly recommended that any R2R DAC application includes a reference buffer. Glitches can occur more easily in R2R DACs due to the number of switches switching between code transitions. The mechanics of the switches in the R2R DAC results in a higher glitch potential for some code transitions. If a single bit changes, the glitch energy is comparable to the glitch energy of the string DAC. However, if more bits change during code transitions, the glitch energy increases. For example, consider the transition from 3 to 4, or in binary 011 to 100. All switches are changed for increasing the output of a single step. Another reason for the higher glitch energy is the break before make behavior in the R2R switches to avoid short-circuiting the reference to ground for a short time. Switching the switches not exactly at the same time can result in a higher glitch energy. In this video, we have covered a widely used DAC topology, which is more complex compared to a string DAC. Nevertheless, it features certain advantages over a simple string DAC, such as increased linearity, and it consumes less chip area. My name is Sabrina from the Institute of Electronics. I hope you have learned something today, but anyway, thanks for watching.